It's the one they call James Hype.
Hey.
Hype. How's it going?
It's really good, thank you. I'm really excited for today's show.
Love your outfit. Talk me through it.
Oh, okay. Whoa. There's a lot to take in.
I don't know whether to start. Let's start at the top and go down.
All right, cool. Well, I know nothing about basketball, so we'll ignore this. But I like the bright colours. This, we just ironed in the dressing room.
Plain white tee.
While I was wearing it.
That's kind of dangerous.
What we did, yeah? We put a towel underneath. And that's why I swear this happened. And my girlfriend's in there. She'd go, no, don't do it. You'll burn him. No, we pulled it off. So, yeah.
Hazard. Someone just shouted hazard. That's what I was thinking. Hang on a minute. Carry on. So you've got what are these louder things you're wearing? Leggings. No, they're not leggings.
They're actually like shell suit.
Shell suits. The old days. So, and then you've got the purple, like, purple socks. Are they like hockey or football socks? I'm not sure. Not clear.
These are football socks and these are purple socks.
Sick. And then the trainers are like Marty McFly, Back to the Future. Boom. Aren't they?
Everyone's that's the nodding. Drip.
You look wicked. No drama. How good was collaborating with Craig David?
Woo! Right. When you get in a room with Craig David and he starts singing, it's like, I can't even explain it. Like, the guy is so talented. It's mad. Like, I've been in a room with loads of people singing and some amazing people. Like, yeah, you're great. You're the best. And then next level.
Then you work with the CD.
Oh my.
But you know, obviously his album was called Born to Do It. When you hear him sing, you're like, I get it. You were born to do it. He riffs, he enjoys it. It's amazing. Did you take anything from him where you thought, I want a bit of that legendary Craig? Because he's been in it so long. Was there anything that rubbed off?
You know, we had like a really big chat afterwards and he's so inspirational just because he's been around for so long and he knows, like, everybody knows him. Like, I know Drake's quoted that Craig David was one of Drake's influences.
Oh yes, he did love a bit of Craig, didn't he, in the old days?
But yeah, like when we were recording the song, he did a bit of a ooh yeah, and I was like, yeah, there it is. We got the classic Craig David ad libs.
He was just like messing around. You're like, yes, there's the hook. Yeah, don't let him out, lock him in.
Exactly that. Yeah.
Have you partied with him? Because he is. Oh, see?
No, I haven't.
Oh.
No, but I'm gutted. that was my gutted reaction.
I thought that you were going to tell me some story.
No, I wish I had. Like, I've been in Ibiza with him a couple of times. And
you've not raved with him?
He's that guy who, he disappears as soon as he comes off stage. I reckon he goes to, like, a secret after party, to be honest.
Really? Because, you know, he's the guy that, like, does parties in Miami, Ibiza, London. But maybe he just parties, but then on a professional one, he just disappears. And like you say, goes to the undercover.
Work and play balance, maybe. Yeah, maybe.
Who else would be your dream collaboration to work with on the list?
The Weeknd.
Oh, yes.
Drake.
Oh.
And Mabel.
Sick. Well, I think Mabel's here tonight, so perhaps that's you could talk to her. And she's vegan. Oh, well, that's strategic. I love that. She's vegan. So if you've got any, like, vegan snacks for her, that could tempt her.
Don't know about that, but
yeah, maybe not. Christmas time, what are you asking for? More wild socks and shoes and that?
Shoes would be good, yeah, shoes would be good. I haven't really.
But no Red Bull, he doesn't need Red Bull, by the way.
Hey, you know, now, you know what it is? It gets to this time of year and, like, the decorations go up and you start seeing them and you're like, nah, seriously.
I know, that's how I feel. So I take it you've not bought any decorations or presents or anything yet?
I haven't bought anything.
But what's your, I mean, I'm terrible. I normally literally do my Christmas shopping on Christmas Eve. All the shops shut at like 2-3. I'm running around like a mad woman. What's your typical Christmas day like? Are you the same?
Yeah, trust me.
So what is your Christmas day like though, once you've actually got the presents last minute and they're arriving Amazon Boxing Day?
It's cool. It's like, it's a chilled family thing. Like, it's always, you know what? It is a bit overhyped, isn't it, Christmas? I feel like it's a bit overhyped because everyone gets that excited and then it's like, right, now we sit here and wait to eat.
In a food coma.
Yeah, same afterwards and then go to bed.
But do you do like anything, did you do like the Watch the Only Fools and Horses thing or do you play Trivial Pursuit and all that?
Yeah, Monopoly is fun, but it can go horribly wrong.
I want to take everyone down with my property empire when I play Monopoly. Are you the same or?
And then there's always someone who robs the bank as well.
That would be you, isn't it?
I didn't say that.
Any New Year's resolutions for James Hype?
New Year's resolutions. Don't iron t-shirts while wearing them.
I mean, yeah.
Try and play it safe.
Your girlfriend's right, it's a hazard. Dressed. Yeah, let's not burn you before, you know, it's all going so well for you.
Yeah, that's the main one, really.
Well, are you excited for your performance? Because you were so amazing on stage. I love the energy. I'm all about energy, and I love the energy that you give. It's like you couldn't give any more percents on stage.
That is what I said when I got off stage.
Yeah.
The other day when I performed for Hits Live in Liverpool, I came off stage and I was so drained. But like the energy that I got back off the crowd was just so amazing.
Yeah.
And that's what it's all about for me. So yeah, I'm really excited. I'm the first to perform today. So I feel like it's like a challenge to give them the energy and get them ready for all the other amazing acts.
They're going to be like, slapped, like, whoa. But I think it's cool. I think it's great that you leave it all on the stage. Was there ever a time in your career where you have you kind of ramped up to this type of performance?
Oh, definitely.
Were you ever like the kind of shy DJ that was like kind of...
Yeah, like that guy who like won't pick up the microphone. Yeah.
But that's nice. That's nice for people to, you know, like aspiring DJs and producers to look at you and think, you know, I'm like that. I know I've got talent, but I'm a bit shy. And then now I could be like you, you know?
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Any messages for any DJs or aspiring producers?
Oh, just keep going. Just keep going. Like you can live your dream if you keep going and work hard and just be who you want to be. That's all you got to do.
Nice. Oh, it's so nice to talk to you.
Likewise.
Good luck for the opening set. It's live.